Please remain standing while I ask Mr. Lewis to lead the prayer, Mr. Matthews to lead the pledge. Let's all remember Commissioner John Warren Garner tonight. If y'all don't know, he's in the hospital, he's had a rub out. John Warren has served this county for many, many years with his own style and flair, so he needs our prayer tonight. All right, let's pray. Dear the Father, we gather before you tonight as a dedicated servant of this county. Seek your guidance, wisdom, and grace as we convene this commissioner meeting. Grant us tonight the insight to make decisions that will benefit the well-being of our community and its residents. May our discussions be filled with understanding, respect, and shared commitment to the greater good. Ask that you bless each commissioner present with the strength to lead with integrity and compassion. Help us to work collaboratively, putting aside personal interests for the betterment of all. We pray for the safety and prosperity of our county's residents, for your divine guidance in all that we do. May our decisions reflect the wisdom, justice, and love. Father, pray for Johnny Garner tonight. Pray that you be with doctors and nurses that are working with him in the hospital. Father, pray that you will give him peace. Pray that you'll give him strength and help him to regain his strength. Father, pray this all in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Yes, sir. I move that with the first election.
Nomination cease?
Yes.
Is there a second?
I'll second.
We have a second. got the chair.
Well, I thank you and I appreciate the opportunity to serve again as chairman. And I just thank each and every one of you. Would though we need to proceed on with the agenda, which is the election of the chairman pro tem.
Mr. Mayor, I would like to nominate Renee Hooks.
Mr. Mayor, I'd like to nominate Dan Moore.
On the first nomination, like Renee Phelps.
I second.
We have a second. And on the second nomination of Ann Moore.
I second that.
We have a second also. So, any other nomination for chairman pro tem?
May that nomination cease.
We have a motion to cease nomination and.
Second.
We have a second for cease nomination and we'll do a roll call vote. If you would, just say the last name of the one that you would choose.
Second, please.
Okay.
Nomination of Renee Phelps and Ann Moore.
So just say the last name. Jerry Love.
Renee.
Kevin Carter. Bubba Edges.
Paul.
Howard Kim.
Paul.
Jerry King.
Paul.
Andrea Hobb.
Moore.
Carolyn Hickens.
Paul.
Ann Moore.
Abby Keys.
Dwight Bingham.
Phelps.
Renee. Jerry Emerson.
Moore.
Tim Crow.
Phelps.
Barry Smith.
Phelps.
Brenda Matthews.
Phelps.
Todd Lewis.
Phelps.
Ricky Hardy.
Phelps.
Mike Alexander.
Moore.
So it's my understanding we have to have a majority in order to have a chairman. We have to have 10 votes to have a majority.
Stacy, who do you, excuse me, Stacy, who do you have as a witness for Ms. Moore? Who do you have for Ms. Moore?
She has Sam.
I'll get you out.
Because my asking didn't add up here, that's why I was asking.
But what?
Your numbers didn't add up. I didn't have down for it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And then two didn't vote. And then Johnny's not here. We're going to have to vote over.
Since there was not enough.
Okay, Jerry Love.
Phelps.
Kevin Fowler. Bubba Edgett.
Four.
Al McKinnon.
Four.
Jerry King.
Four.
Andrea Holland.
Four.
Johnny Connor's not here. Carolyn Higgins.
Four.
And you gonna vote?
Yes. I guess I vote myself.
Dwight Bingham.
Yes.
Renee. You not vote? Terry Emerson.
Four.
Tim Crow.
Fails.
Barry Smith.
Fails.
Brenda Matthews.
Fails.
Todd Lewis.
Fails.
Ricky Hardy.
Fails.
Mike Alexander.
Four.
We inquired with, Mr. Marty, what is the procedure here with non-majority?
Well, it doesn't pass without the votes. It's majority provision. Apparently, Ms. Moore has nine votes. Ms. Phelps has seven. Takes 10 for majority.
One more time?
Third vote. Jerry Love.
Yes.
Kevin Fowler.
Four.
Bubba Edgett.
Four.
Al McKinnon.
Four.
Jerry King.
Four.
Andrea Holland.
Four.
Carolyn Higgins.
Four.
Dan Moore.
Four.
Dwight Bingham.
Yes.
Renee Phelps.
Two.
Jerry Emerson.
Four.
Tim Crow.
Yes.
Barry Smith.
Fails.
Brenda Matthews.
Fails.
Todd Lewis.
Fails.
Ricky Hardy.
Fails.
Mike Alexander.
Four.
Sam Alkins. Nine, seven.
Now, the majority, what do we advise to do, Marty? Third vote.
Vote again, or not have a chairman pro temp? For voting for next meeting?
Yes, what's that about?
We will continue with chairman pro temp as of now, with Commissioner Tim Crow, and we'll vote on this at our next meeting.
Is it 75%
of this one, y'all? It's the majority of our whole commission. Which would be all of you. So, we'll carry on with the agenda. We have committee reports, the budget committee, budget amendments.
I said everybody got their package of budget amendments. First, again, you did me, go over these weeks ago. If you have any questions, I'm sure each department head is here, and they can answer any questions you might have about their budget amendments. These were committee recommendations, so I wouldn't make the motion. Any questions, feel free to ask them in the department.
Kim, I've got one question. It was someone in the audience last time, and the budget committee, they asked about the total payment on some of those salaries.
Yes.
And I think we need to vote on that. I think all that needs to come back.
Gary, do you want to address that, Chair? Do you want to address that?
Man, we can short them, they can come back and stop it.
Yes, there was an overpayment. I think it came about $6,000. The owners found that immaterial, said no adjustments were necessary. Now, my understanding is if you commissioners vote to have each employee pay it back, then that's your call, or no.
We can include that as a budget then, can we not, Mr. Gary?
Yeah, again, as far as I know, Marty has some other insight. I would like some guidance on how you want that repaid, you know, with one check or stretch for the rest of the fiscal year, or how you'd like to do it.
What's on average per people?
I want to, you know, from memory, I think it was around $250, $300. I think mine was maybe like $335 or something, and I think the highest was maybe $471, something like that. But again, if you decide to take it back, then I would appreciate some guidance, since we want to stretch for the rest of the fiscal year, or how you'd like to do it.
We've got a...
On the budget.
We have a budget for all the other budget amendments. We have a motion, because they passed through the budget committee. Excluding this, we'll vote on the next. We'd like to, with a motion and a second. We have a second.
A second.
And a second also, vote on the edge.
This is a perfect budget amendment, Wes. I didn't hear it.
The budget amendment is the budget committee approved.
This would be Wes, what, Ms. Matthews?
Wes, the third question.
Okay. Jerry Low. Kevin Baldwin.
Yes.
Bobby Edgerton.
Yes.
Al McKinnon.
Yes.
Jerry King.
Yes.
Andrea Holland.
Yes.
Carolyn Higgins.
Yes.
Dan Moore.
Yes.
Dwight Bingham.
Yes.
Renee Phelps.
Yes.
Jerry Emerson.
Yes.
Tim Crow.
Yes.
Larry Smith.
Yes.
Brenda Matthews.
Yes.
Todd Lewis.
Yes.
Ricky Hardy.
Yes.
Mike Alexander.
Yes.
17 in favor.
Motion passed for the budget amendments, excluding the one mentioned by Matthews. Just the clarification, would you like to just tell more about what she's asking about the salaries?
My understanding is you're wanting all the employees to pay back the amount that were overpaid during fiscal year ending June 30th, 2023.
$6,000 makes a lot of money.
It's a overpayment. When we consider it as a budget amendment, it worked out in the budget as of this year. And he is asking, do we go ahead and make a motion to accept that and work it out in the year?
The only thing I would say is, have you already paid it back? Didn't have some of the officials pay it back?
As far as I know, one person did.
The only thing I would say is it was a mistake. And I hate that mistake happened. But there are people out there that can afford to pay it back pretty quick. And there are some people, I'm sure, work for the county, that money, they need that. And it was a mistake. We're going to have to pay it back. I would just suggest that we don't penalize them so hard for our mistake. If they're going to have to pay it back, it should be smaller increments instead of just hitting them. If John Doe was $300, $300 lead one time, made perfect. I would just ask that we take that into consideration.
As far as I know, that's until the job will be when you want to.
This is something that has never happened, and it has been, Gary is involved, she tasked, and they they know all about it and audited, and it will be worked out with the employees out of their checks in the future. And this is CTAS's way to their suggestion, correct?
No, sir. This is the immaterial overpayment that the auditor said it was an accounting error. There's no way to correct it. This did not involve the elected officials. Those have been worked out with CTAS advice and the advice of the auditors. This is right to file to us, to everybody except the elected officials.
Is there any other questions about this?
Not about that. I have something about this letter from auditor. We have our tax. It says, expenditure is not appropriated, but you have a copy of this letter, please? What's this mean?
Al's asking about on page 2 of 3 of the auditor's report, about 3/4 of the way down, expenditure is not appropriated. During our review of the budget, we noted that your most recent audit has a finding of actual expenditures exceeding budget appropriations. There were budget line items in which the expenditures for the year exceeded the budget that was allotted to that line item. In other words, we spent more than the budget on certain line items. Again, my error, I apologize. I should have closed out the purchasing cycle earlier in June than I did. That way I was able to buy my instrument over. So that's what we're talking about here.
I'm
weekly, and at the end of the fiscal year, they still got paid a check, which at the end of the year didn't make the budget work out correct. And some of the employees got overpaid, and he caught this right away, but it had already been deposited into people's accounts. So we had, his solution was with, to pay it back from the employees, a small amount of checks to even it out.
Mr. Chair, I'm going to, what you're describing is what happened with elected officials. The elected officials were guaranteed a minimum salary, and those were overpaid. So to make minimum salaries for both year ends, June 30, 2023, and June 30, 2024, according to the city as the elders, we may adjust to elected officials' pay for this current year again to make those 2 years come out correct. What we're talking about here is because of the change in pay grade, there was overpayment to the other employees, not the elected officials. That's what we're talking about here. That has not been adjusted. So what we're talking about here is pulling that back out of their checks over the remainder of this fiscal year.
So we have a motion and a payment. As long as everyone understands the reason that it happened, we have a motion and a second, and it passed by majority.
I think it's passed, but I'm just making a point that I don't believe that they should be voting on something that directly involved me.
Yes, ma'am.
Thank you.
On with the agenda.
Well, that's about half the information.
Other committees have any reports? And I will get a response back to you. she explained the reason it was not to us again, or they left at the hospital.
It was losing our will.
Yeah.
They had it for over 3 years, passed.
Next on the agenda is other committees. Do we have any reports from any other committees? If not, onto the agenda with a solid waste report from Ms. Amber Green.
Can everybody hear me? Just want to make sure everybody can hear me. Okay, before I get started, so I'm about to ask for grant funding from the sale of recycling from our accounts. This is money that the solid waste department and the recycling have already have in our sale of recycling account. So I'm not asking for any fees, any taxes, or any more income from anyone in the room. I just want everyone to make sure they understand that. So I'm going to be going over two things tonight. One is a grant from the recycling partnership, and the other is our BACO at the solid waste department. And as I go through this, anyone is welcome to ask me any questions, just raise your hand. So on August 8th, the solid waste committee met at the solid waste department and talked about the recycling partnership grant and BACO. The recycling hub has received a $535,000 grant from the recycling partnership. This grant is for two robotic arms and a building expansion. I'm going to explain what the robots are going to do. So the robotic arms will give the hub the opportunity to recycle number 5 plastics, which is yogurt cups, Oreo trays, shampoo bottles. It's stuff that we do not recycle now. And this will help us increase the amount of number 1 plastics being recycled on our sort line. So currently on our sort line, we have inmate labor that hand pick off plastics. And they are very overwhelmed because of the amount of plastics we are getting in is a lot. So with this robot is going to help us pick off 90 picks a minute of the plastic. And what that is going to do is bring in more revenue for the recycling operations for this county. It's going to save the county on their landfill bill by increasing the recycling also. The robots will also help on labor issues when we do not have the people to sort recycling. You know, sometimes the jail has 6 people, sometimes they can give us 7, sometimes they can only give us 4. So with this grant, these robotic arms are going to take the place of a human being to help us pull off the material that we're supposed to be recycling and making money off of. The solid waste department has a reserve fund balance from the sale of recycling of $851,000. This is not updated in your commissioner's package yet because Gary and I talked Friday and we had to transfer the sale of recycling money over. And that money can only be used for recycling projects and recycling operations. This money does not use taxpayer money and is money that was made from the sale of recycling, and it can only be used for the recycling operations. Before I go to the next thing, because I'm going to talk about our BACO next, does anybody on the county commission have any questions about our grant that we got from the recycling partnership? Yes, sir. My chairman of the solid waste committee.
I'm confused here.
Okay, let me try to explain it.
Say, what was that money restricted though, man?
It's restricted, and the doctors can help with this, and maybe Gary can help with this, but that money is made from the sale of recycling. We have to use that money for our recycling operations. And we have a regulatory authority called the Tennessee Department of Environment and Conservation. When they gave us $8 million worth of grant funding to start this hub and spoke, we have to have a reserve fund as a county to be able to run that hub and spoke. So they are also part of the reason why that money is restricted.
Was that brought up by county
committee? That was brought up by audit because I went and visited Ms. Vicki when we were going through all this, because the budget committee tried to pull, I don't know how much money they tried to take out of our reserve fund. But because that money is restricted, you can't pull it. Because if you are operating a recycling center and you take all of my money to run the recycling center, it's going to close. And we've talked about this before in past meetings, but we have to have operation money And so let me go back a couple years. Now, my solid waste committee 2 years ago told me if I could write a grant for a building addition and robotic arms, that I could have them as long as we had money. The same committee the other night that you were on agreed for me to stand up here and present this project to the whole county commission, and that's why I'm standing here.
We did.
Okay.
So I just want people to understand.
Right.
And if it's quite restricted, that they see this money sitting in this county, like.
We do.
It's money, so we need to make sure everybody's aware what.
It's restricted because the Tennessee Department of Environmental Conservation restricts it, so we can run a hub and spoke. And that building is saving you money on your landfill bill. And let me turn around this way. So when you recycle, you save money on your landfill bill. It's going to keep your solid waste disposal fee from going up. Raise your hand if you recycle in this room. Raise your hand. All right, thank you, because you're saving the county money. If you didn't raise your hand, you're costing the county money. You're putting trash in the landfill, and that is not making money, it is costing money. Our landfill bill is $35,000 to $45,000 a month right now. The people moving in here, and I mean, everyone creates trash every day. Our landfill fee is going to go up 2% every month. When we come out of contract, we pay $41.32 now, we're looking at $70 to $80 a ton, you know, in the next 4 years. Your solid waste fee is going up. To keep it from going up, please recycle. That is the only way we have to keep it from going up to $14, $15, $16 per month.
Tell them how much the county recycles versus cities. They need to hear that.
So the county recycling is at 18%. We need more people in the county to recycle. The cities do amazing. They're between 40 to 42% because they have curbside carts. I wish I could put curbside carts in the county and run around to everyone's house in this county for recycling. That would be amazing. But I have to write grants, and I cannot do that without having grant money or having the funding for that. So more people in the county need to recycle. We go about carts. We do education and outreach. You know, we give out blue bags. I don't know what else to do to get you guys to recycle. I understand you have jobs and families just like we do. We try to make it as easy and convenient as we possibly can for you to recycle.
Did you say you could get a grant for a truck?
Yes, sir, I can. Yep, I gotta have an employee to run it if I run a county route. It would be a full-time job.
You're not being recycled. That's $720,000.
Yes. I can, and we can definitely look at that, but it takes time to do that. And right now we're trying to work on the processing part, which is the robotic arms and the expansion. Please come and tour our facilities if you've never been. I welcome you to come. Our tip floor, which is where we dump the materials that you're recycling, where we process, is tiny. With this addition, we are adding 5,000 square feet on, and that's going to help us be able to process more material. So, and yes, we can look at a truck in the future, but one grand at a time. All right, I'm going to keep going. Does anyone else have any questions on the grant? Okay. So the solid waste department needs a backhoe. So we have a backhoe now that we've currently been using for years. The pin on it is broke because we pack furniture, metal, and recycling boxes down. And by packing boxes with that, we can actually make more space in our boxes. So we're constantly packing boxes and open top boxes, packing metal and furniture. You guys have a lot of furniture and TVs and all kinds of stuff that we pack all the time. I mean, last year we had 900 tons of just furniture come to our office. That's a lot of furniture. So we are constantly packing. And this time we're looking at a track loader, because you know it's going to help with the packing part. And that ranges between $60,000 and $70,000 for a track loader. And so since we don't have any money from anywhere else, and we use the backhoe to pack recycling and solid waste boxes, we are going to have to pull this money from this reserve fund because I don't have it anywhere else. And if I didn't have this reserve fund, then I would have to increase your taxes or the solid waste fee to have a backhoe. So we are very thankful that we have this money from the sale of recycling so we can have a backhoe or a track loader. So on August 8th at the solid waste committee meeting, Kevin Bottom made a motion for Amber to present this project to county commission to be able to transfer $400,000 over from the reserve fund to the solid waste budget, and it was seconded by Ricky Hardy. Yes, sir. It was but due to our quote, we can change it if you want to, but we got a quote on the track loader, and we need $10,000. And that is completely up to you. If you want to do $390,000 or $400,000, if we don't transfer the extra $10,000 over, I'm gonna have to flip for my budget now.
It's a used track loader, right?
Yeah.
Do you have $10,000?
I do have $10,000 in my budget, and I can use it for that if you want me to.
Well, Ben, can you make a motion for $390,000?
That's fine, we can keep it that way. I'm good with that, so we can get $390,000 from the sale of the truck. Does anybody have any questions, Mr. Allen, before I keep going?
I don't know, wait, correct.
Okay, that's fine, she can do that, yes, sir.
Is this gonna increase the number of employees you have?
No, the robots are gonna actually help with not having to have more inmate labor. And we use inmate labor, and the jail's very kind to give us inmate labor. They pick on our sort lines all the time, and they help us county save money. They give a day for a day, and we feed them lunch. And Bubba and our employees out there teach them skills that they need to drive forklifts and skid loaders, so when they go back out of society, we hope they can get a job. So, but we don't have as many as we'd like, so that's what these robots are gonna do, is help us with that. That answer your question?
Yes.
Okay. Does anyone else have any other questions?
You said your updated fund balance was $851,000.
Yes, but you can check with Mr. Gary, but yeah.
So this $390,400,000, that's gonna leave you about $400,000. Can you sustain the next, I mean, that's a pretty good deal.
Yes, we can.
And while we explain it, I need to go ahead and explain to them why this truck costs more than what the insurance was.
Are you talking about the new 2024 roll-off truck that we just bought? So we had to do an emergency PO last meeting, Mr. Gary did that for us. So our truck was in an accident, we had to replace the truck, it was completely totaled. Insurance paid $202,000, and we had to pull $42,000 out of that reserve fund balance. And that was just, so our truck that we just wrecked was $180,000, and that's how much a vehicle has went up in the last year and a half, from inflation and cost, and that's why we're looking at a used track loader instead of a new one, so.
And the old truck is a 2022, and the new truck is a 2024, so y'all all know that it's gonna be higher than this one.
That's correct.
Recycling reserve?
Yeah.
And it's still what, $50,000 in a month?
Yes. Are you talking about the truck? Yeah, so I called Kinsler to see if we could get a Kinsler truck. They are 8 to 12 months out on building a truck. I called International and Freightliner, and they are the same. So we found a truck in Kentucky, so we went ahead and bought it because we cannot operate without two trucks at our department. I mean, we've got 25 boxes full of furniture out there right now, and they've all came in the last 8 days. And I mean, we have to have a driver to haul them. I have a driver that's full-time and part-time truck driver. And we're constantly hauling stuff that's all running into the convenience centers. And we service 5 convenience centers with 2 trucks. Any other questions?
Thank you for the information.
Okay, so I need a motion and a second for $390,000 to be transferred over from the sale of recycling to the solid waste budget.
I make a motion.
Right, we have a motion by Bubba Edson.
I don't think Bubba, I made a motion before you, but I don't think you should have been an employee of solid waste.
Okay, I'm sorry. We have a motion of, by Ms. Renee Phelps. We have a second.
I second it.
We have a second by Mr. Jerry Emerson. Any more discussion with the?
I've got a discussion about what Ms. Phelps said. She said that we shouldn't make the motion because we work for the county or we are commissioners. What difference does it make? What difference does it make?
He's an employee of solid waste. Of course, you know that's something that's gonna warrant you that he advantages.
It's not his money.
As of now, I believe the ruling of the state law states that a county employee can serve on the commission.
They can.
He can.
He can make a motion.
He can. But I think it's, I don't think it's morally correct, and that's why I refuse myself from voting any of the drugs, and also, but there are some things that they cannot vote on.
We can't vote on the trustee, and Kip Andrew cannot vote on trustee's office, because I said we're voting now. We don't vote on that.
But you can vote on that.
We have a motion on the floor. Do we have a second? Do we have a second? All right, is there any other discussion on this?
Read that motion.
Motion to transfer $309,000 from the sale of recyclables over to solid waste. Laura, what you got? Can you say that again?
This is transferring money inside the recycling center to pay for.
That's pretty complicated, we got the whole meeting in here, we got it. So here's what I claim from all that, let's see if we can live with it. It says, motion to approve a $535,000 grant to purchase two robotic arms and building expansion and education and outreach. And then, we ask for $390,000 from sale of recyclables, and then I've got these line items. So, and that does equal $390. So, what was the other, the piece of equipment, the track hoe? Education, outreach, and track.
Is there one other?
All in question.
And we need to vote on it.
Terry Lovell.
Yes.
Kevin Thomas.
Yes.
Bubba Ed.
Yes.
Al McKinnon.
Yes.
Jerry King.
Yes.
Andrea Holland.
Yes.
Carolyn Higgins.
Yes.
Anne Moore.
Yes.
Dwight Bingham.
Yes.
Renee Bell.
Yes.
Jerry Emerson.
Yes.
Devin Broad.
Yes.
Barry Smith.
Yes.
Brenda Matthews.
Yes.
Todd Lewis.
Yes.
Ricky Hardy.
Yes.
Mike Alexander.
Yes.
Seventeen in favor.
And two in favor, motion passed.
Thank you.
Next on the agenda, we have approval of the lease for the TCAP building to the state. We have Mr. Brian Harris here now to explain this endeavor of transferring the contract to the TCAP facility. He will explain why, the reason for doing it. Would you like to come up here?
Either way, I'm pretty loud, so I don't usually need a microphone. Barry and I have been in, had conversations for a good while now about the transfer of this building to the, to TCAP Pump and TBR. Well, I think this started about a couple of years ago, in the process. Trying to decide the best way to do this is the best way for all involved. From my understanding, from working with Barry, the best way that we've come up with is for you all to transfer the ownership of the building to TCAP Pump, which in turn is controlled by TBR, on a 30-year lease, I believe what we've been working on. We take over the management of it, and basically most of the upkeep, the contract states what we pay, what you all pay. It's been through our lawyers, it's been through your lawyer. I do understand that there's one change that will have to be made if you all decided that this is something you agree on, is that the city's portion of the building was transferred to the county a few days ago. We have not had time to push that back through our lawyers and to allow that to be changed in the contract. That would be a short process to have done. Our takeover idea was to take over October 1st. That's not a set in stone situation. It's just something that it's coming and it's here and it's now and we can move forward. One thing we a few things we talked about was the possibilities of additional educational opportunities there at the site. As you all know, if you've been to the building, it's a low building. It limits what we can offer there from educational opportunities. But there are so many opportunities there that can be housed in that building, just in the state that it's in. Also, us taking over the building gives us the right to, you know, make additions, to make changes, that type of situation. Once again, our grant talk here tonight, grant money devices and things like that. So, with you all's approval and everything, we would like to be a part of the state department of Henderson and Chester County. And this passes, we look forward to continuing on and doing what we're doing, working in education for our young people and people like me and girls. So any questions, I'll try to answer them. If I do not have the answer, I will try to find it.
What are the benefits for Chester County out of this thing?
You'll stop spending as much money on the building, that's one thing. The other thing is just allowing us the opportunity to offer different types of education to different students. Like I said, the building, I hate to even try to get into what we could offer there because, you know, you have pros and cons both ways. It's one person likes and one person doesn't. Once we had control of it, then there's never been a problem with what we've done there. You all have always allowed us to do what we wanted to. But it would allow us to make those decisions. Whether it's a manufacturing-based situation, one program that's been discussed quite a few times is an industrial maintenance type program, which would require, we can still house low ceilings and things like that. Our welding program is at the high school, which is a perfect location for us because it's a dual enrollment program along with an evening adult program, already set up, already there, high-day shop. Everything's perfect in that situation. Not something like that can be moved, but new things coming in. We know Blue Oval City is the biggest talk we have in West Tennessee right now. I don't know how that will affect us here in Chester County and Henderson, but we know because don't hold this against me, but I'm Wayne County in that direction. So I saw what happened with Saturn and all those, the growth around that. There'll be satellite growth to Blue Oval City. We know, no matter what. And of course, the industry you already have here in the county, they're our biggest supporters and our biggest partners. So, we don't want to take anything away from them. We want to be able to provide training for their employees. And I rambled, so I don't know if I answered your question or not.
You did. Great.
Don't we already have part of that building rented out to somebody?
Yes, and that contract will just change over to them. That's job.
So that will make that money that you're getting from them?
Yes, they will.
Unification or?
Yes, the half that was going into the landscaping.
I have a question. This is definitely in county three, but I haven't sent a copy of the lease. So can you specify? You said that the most expenses would be incurred. What expenses would be incurred by the county
three? One of the biggest expenses that we talked about, through our lawyers, your lawyers, and Mary, probably one that we balance back and forth most was the maintenance of the heating and air system. That's probably one of the more expensive things to maintain. We agreed in the contract that we would split the cost of the maintenance and the replacement of those systems. Everything else we would take over. We would take over the custodial, the lawn care. Mary, whatever I'm missing, jump in with me. We've been over this so many times before. Utilities. The insurance you would keep because we cannot pay someone else's insurance. That's a TBR, state situation. The insurance would be yours. But the other parts would be covered.
If you expand the building and expand the heating and air, which they're not paying for?
Yes. If it breaks.
No, he's talking about on the expanding part.
Expanding. I'm sorry. I'm always here. Okay.
If you expand the building and add additional air conditioning heat, we're going to be something
else. No, just what's there in the original building. The maintenance of what's already there. I'm sorry. I didn't hear that.
Appreciate it.
See,
he
wants to
know
the questions to be asked.
Have a good day. I'd like to look at it before we make a motion.
That's what he was explaining. The city was a part of the title on the building, and in their meeting Thursday night, they passed out a quick claim deed just issued to the county. So it had to be sent back Friday, and it hadn't returned yet, because it had to go back to the state.
Okay, I see what we're doing. We'd like to see what it is.
Okay. We can have it back, we'll have to have it on our next agenda. So we'll have to change, we'll have to change the dates on it.
That's no problem on our side, as far as that goes.
All right, I appreciate you. Any more questions? Give us a call, TK Brown, and I'll try to make sure we find the lines. Thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
Next on the agenda, we have the approval of the county committees. Chair by, what I would like to do is in our first meeting, we select the chair of the council. We have a motion to approve, we have a second.
I
Right now, the current resolution that was approved in 1976, states minimum distance from a church that business is allowed to sell packaged beer from is 2,000 foot. I would like to ask the commission to consider changing the distance to 500 or to no restriction at all as other counties around us have done. As of right now, most of the sales are going to nearby stores, which is Madison County, resulting in lost revenue for the county. And by lowering this restriction, it will increase revenue for the county, no cost to the public, and will also guarantee the future of local business. Thank you.
He is asking us to change the distance.
Make a motion to change the is there any restrictions?
Currently, the law is the state law is 2,000 feet, and that's what we've adopted. We haven't changed it. He asked for 500, but your
motion is 500 feet.
We have a motion in a second. Change it, yes.
Do we know what the payments of the church is? Is there anybody representing the church here? I'd like to hear what they're, me personally, I'd like to hear what they're saying.
I've talked to a few of the members, and I mean, they will come right out and say that, yeah, we're on board, but I mean, but they are will. I mean, kind of just, you know, they understand the kind of it is and what they can change. I mean, still one might be selling it on Sundays.
I'll be honest with you, I just need to see speak from that unit speaking. I mean, before we make this radical change.
I know this is off the agenda, but do we have anybody to come in on this topic at the moment? Do you need to go into the audience?
I think we need the revenue for the county. It's the point people are going to drive to another county anyway. You can't legislate around.
Mr. Devil, I have had some members of the church to contact them since it is in our district. And the ones that have called me, I mean, I'm speaking to them because they asked me to, but they were on board, really, redoing it.
Would there be any other comments, commissioners, or what the?
I know my son-in-law drives to Madison County, which lives right there within a quarter mile. So.
We have a motion in a second on the floor. So we do think that if there is any more discussion, we will need to bring it to a vote.
Is this the thing not to approve it? Is this what we're talking about?
The motion is to change the distance of the sale of beer from 2,000 feet to 500 feet.
And that would be countywide.
That also would be countywide. This would be for the whole county.
We're changing the churches. I agree. Yeah. Yeah, they
I think we'll
table
it
to the next
meeting. I'll say.
If you have a
motion,
request
the
table.
You can make a motion. Yeah. We're making a motion. So, what about the rest of the county? I mean, there's other people that aren't members of those churches that might not have an objection.
All right, we have a motion to table this subject. We agree to roll call for table.
Terry Lowe, to table the motion for new meeting. Kevin Faulkner.
Yes.
Bubba Edgerton.
Yes.
Al McKinnon.
No.
Jerry King.
Yes.
Andrea Hall.
Yes.
Carolyn Dickens.
Yes.
Ann Moore.
Yes.
Dwight Baker.
This is to table it to the next meeting.
Yes.
Renee Phelps.
Yes.
Greg Emerson.
Yes.
Tim Crow.
Yes.
Barry Smith.
Yes.
Brenda Matthews.
Yes.
Todd Lewis.
Yes.
Ricky Hardy.
Yes.
Mike Alexander.
Yes.
16-1, motion tabled.
Motion is tabled, we'll bring this topic up at our next mission. Next, we have Mr. Todd Lewis. Do you have something to do with that?
They, you're gonna have to do it the next time, it was by the graduation, they could be here tonight, so they'll need to be at the next meeting.
Okay, thank you. Next meeting also. Next on here, we have public comment, if any more would like to express your comment at this time. About anything on the agenda, anything coming up. If not, we'll move on with our agenda, any other business to discuss. Yes, Commissioner Higgins.
I've got a question for that. Why do you think the issue of the age of life budget is so important to college? Todd, or is it still we work with the county?
Yes, and I refuse myself when it had to be.
No, you didn't.
Okay.
A few minutes ago, you did.
Okay. We'll find this under consideration.
Yeah, let's get an answer for that, because every other person makes a motion on here.
Every other person wants to.
What?
Every other person wants to.
Everybody makes a motion regardless. I make a motion on the trustee's office. Have you heard me make a motion? Yes.
And you should.
Well, I do. I mean, it's not involving money.
You're talking legal or moral?
It's not involving money.
Both. There are certain things that cannot go wrong. We'll talk about it.
Yes, we need our exact state.
I mean, it works in here, so you're gonna make it fair.
That's right.
There's six people right now that work for the county on our board.
I should be able to work for the county if I was mayor, but it's not the case.
I'm talking about your individual department.
We'll get the ruling on this.
I didn't say that there's some things that you can, but I'm saying there's some things that you shouldn't.
I'm saying a lot of people should.
Okay. Next on the agenda, we have approval of notes.
Yes, sir, we have five. There's a little backstory on this. And that is, when I became clerk, I was told that I was a notary because I was a clerk. And that is true, it's only for documents in the clerk's office, not outside documents. So tonight, Stacy Smith, Melissa Esposito, Tawana Rowland, Joshua Borrello, and Lori Q. Thomas, asking for notes.
I should tell her. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? If not, on to the agenda.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry, excuse me. We have one other thing on other business, I'm sorry. We have the Highway Department equipment list here. And he's highlighted in the highlighter item number. Well, here he is to explain.
This is our principal equipment list. And I highlighted that also all of them through the same company and the department. Any other questions about that, I guess?
Motion to approve the highway equipment, second.
We have a motion by Commissioner Todd, second by Commissioner Higgins.
I'm sorry. I didn't hear what you said.
use. Is there any other questions?
No.
Any other discussion?
Yes, sir.
We have the
air. Like, oh, no, they're going to do the air.
We have the study back and the study of the downstairs. Any upstairs was within normal range. Matter of fact, the upstairs was in a small little lot. All right, so next to the, going back. Yes, I'm sorry. I should have answered the next question. We have a motion and a second to approve road list.
No, we did, but I'm sorry. That's me.
And all in favor of that?
All in favor, that's me. I'm sorry. I got the wrong sheet. Okay. Roll off.
Now, back to the answer of Commissioner Edgy's question. Study that was done in the public safety building, the downstairs was within normal range, and the upstairs, it showed that it was not enough moisture in there. So that is the study that was done by the, we have the results.
Can we get that study?
Thank you.
Yes.